Barbers.
I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Joanne.
And today, Mum is going to be doing her Starbucks collection.
Okay, the plan is to do three of these videos. I've got lots of Starbucks mugs. The first range that I started collecting was the City Icon range. So today I'm going to be doing my City Icon range of Starbucks mugs. It's quite a big collection, so bear with me. If you want to grab a cup of tea and some biscuits, then that's fine. If you're a fellow Starbucks mug collector, then you'll know how special these mugs are. One of the reasons I started collecting Starbucks mugs in 2014 was because I wanted to sort of like keep a track of where I'd been, the places I'd visited, and I do use these mugs. They get used in order. they're all kept downstairs in like a glass cabinet. And whenever like my husband or me or Caitlin are like downstairs, I like be like, which mug is it tonight? Bring up Madrid.
Yeah.
And then Madrid will get used. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to start from the very first mug that I got in this range, and I'm going to work through them chronologically. So you can see the order that I got them. These are my favourite range of mugs as well. So it all started in January 2014 when I got my first mug. Do you want to pass me Paris? So I went on a girls' trip. I go on a girls' trip every January with some lovely ladies. And the first one that we did in 2014 was Paris. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous mug. It's the first one I got, so it does mean a lot to me. And it is dark red on the inside. And on the bottom of these, you can see that there are 16 fluid ounces. My favourite size of mug. It's perfect for hot chocolate. So that was my first one. Bought that in the centre of Paris. Right, do you want to pass me Edinburgh? Because Edinburgh is number two. You can add to this story in a minute.
Okay.
So me and Caitlin had a trip up to Edinburgh. I think it was 2014. Yeah, this is still still spring. 2014. We climbed Arthur's Seat. We had a lovely couple of days in the city centre together. And I decided to get the Edinburgh mug as the second mug of my collection. When I've just, it's not a funny story for me, but it's a funny story for Caitlin. And it's navy blue on the inside. So we found a lovely Starbucks in the centre of Edinburgh.
It's my turn to say the story.
Yeah, you tell the story.
So me and Mum went to a Starbucks in Edinburgh. I think it was just after we climbed out the seat and we wanted a little rest. So we went and got a coffee, and I think I got like a baby chino. And Mum spilled half the coffee down her.
I always get my coffee from Starbucks or Costa extra hot. And it just completely spilled all down
so
me.
So we had to go to the toilet. And then there was this like little hand dryer, like when you wash your hands.
I think they know.
And then Mum had to like get a jumper and she had to go like that.
It was a good job. It was like a boiling hot day. So I did dry quite quickly. And the people in Starbucks were really, really sweet. And they gave me like a replacement drink. Right, the next one.
London.
This is another navy blue one. I got this in January 2015. This was our second January girls trip. Got this from London. Got it from a Starbucks that was just near Tower Bridge. And it does have Tower Bridge on the mug, so I was really chuffed about that.
Are we going to see a show
in London? We will, we'll have to go. We went to go see Billy Elliot. That was the weekend we went to see Billy Elliot. So there's London.
Is it Belfast now?
No, could you pass me... Oh, you were here for this one as well. Can you pass me Madrid?
Oh, yes. Ooh, with the little bear on.
So the fourth one from 2015, we had a family trip for a few days. Me, my husband John and Caitlin, we went to Madrid in February 2015.
I like the colour of that one.
I love the colour of this one. It's like a lime green. So again, it's the 16 fluid ounce. And the statue of the bear with the cherry tree
is... We got a magnet of that.
We did get a fridge magnet of that. I collect fridge magnets as well, wherever I go. I can't remember which branch of... I don't think there's a story towards this one. I think this was just quite a boring go in, buy the mug and then come out.
Yeah.
Yeah, no real story attached to this one, but I would love to go back to Madrid. I do love Madrid. And I love the colour of that one. Right, the next one. Can you pass me Monaco, please?
We got here for this one.
No. So, in the space of like a week, it was a complete fluke. It wasn't planned like this. We went to Madrid in February 2015. We literally landed back at Liverpool Airport, and 12 hours later, we went back to Liverpool Airport to fly to Monaco because my husband had tickets for a boxing fight.
And I stayed with my grandparents.
You did? So, this is 2015. got bought in the February from the, I think there was only one branch of Starbucks in Monaco back then. I don't know whether there's more now. I feel like this is my most exclusive Starbucks mug just because at the time there was only one branch of Starbucks in Monaco and it was the only place that you could get it. And it's got the castle and the rock and it's a lovely dark red colour. I bought this in the pouring rain. I dragged my husband all around Monaco trying to find the one branch of Starbucks. But I was just glad to have got it. I love my Monaco one.
You know those two mugs? Those were the teeth where I literally had no teeth.
Oh.
Because these two came out. I think like that one came out.
That might be true, actually. Okay, could you pass me Manchester, please?
Ooh. Oh, look at that colour.
So Manchester is our home city. I am so chuffed that the Manchester one is purple because purple is like my favourite colour and they don't do many purple ones in this range.
It matches your jumper.
It does. Completely matches my jumper. I bought this in October 2015 on a day out in Manchester for my mum's 60th birthday. So I wanted the Manchester one for a while, but I wanted something to like attach it to, like a memory to attach it to, not just going into town and buying the Manchester mug. So it was a day out that we went for something to eat, went to the cinema, had a few drinks in town, and I ended up getting the mug.
Was I there?
To remember. No, you weren't. I think you were still a bit too young. It wasn't going to be the Martian. So it's got the Central Library on the front. Central Library is a beautiful building. Manchester. It's one of my favourite buildings in town. It says Manchester on the back. And now I'm so glad that I've got one from my home city. Okay, I think it's Barcelona.
Oh, we're not here for this one.
Our third January girls trip was to Barcelona. So this was 2016, January 2016.
Look, can I start having
girly trips? Navy blue again. We will see.
It's so sad.
It's navy blue.
I'm going to guess which one is next.
And I bought this one. We were at this really lovely hotel. I can't put the name of the street. It's like the main street in Barcelona and it's like lined with trees and there was a Starbucks like next door but one to our hotel, so that's the branch of Starbucks that I got this mug from.
Belfast.
Yes. Oh,
this was the only girl trip I've ever been on.
This was the first mug that I didn't buy while I was actually in the city. So we went to Belfast in 2013.
Yes.
Which was before I started collecting the mugs.
Oh.
But we've got a local village hotel just down the road from us. And one day, we were in the little mini Starbucks in there, and they had the Belfast mug. I couldn't believe it. I saw it on the shelf. Usually they only have like the Manchester one and the England one. But for some reason, when I went in, they had like Belfast, Dublin, Wales, Edinburgh, and all the other like major cities. So I decided to pick up the Belfast one when I was there because I'd been to Belfast in 2013, but I wasn't collecting the mugs then. It has got the kissing fish on the front. There were five of us that went to Belfast and we all took our turns of kissing the fish, didn't we?
Yeah.
And on the back, it's got the docks and it's the first mug that I got that was a lovely pale blue.
I love that hotel. We stayed in this really nice hotel.
We did.
It had like a spiral staircase. Roads.
Okay. We're moving on to the summer of 2016 now. My first brown mug. So in 2016, we took our family holiday to Rhodes. One day we decided to just hop on a bus and go to Rhodes Old Town because that was where the nearest Starbucks branch was. And the people in there were really, really lovely. It was a really, really big Starbucks branch and it was just near the sea and the harbour. And on the back of the mug, we've got the castle ruins that are in Rhodes Old Town. On the front of the mug, you've got the Acropolis, and we did a day trip to the Acropolis, so I was really glad that the two main things that we saw in Rhodes were actually on the mug. You can see inside that it's a brown colour, and again, it's 16 fluid ounces. We're going to run downstairs now and put all these mugs back and get the next batch. We will see you in a minute.
But it's so funny because we have, like, big cups, so whenever, like, Granada and Carol come around. They have like small mugs at home, and they always say that our mugs are like potties and like bathtubs.
We'll be back in five.
So we're back.
We've got the next batch for you. Could you pass me the Netherlands?
I love this colour.
Oh, I've got a guess. This is Deacon. If you can see him, he's sat next to me. He's a Boston Terrier.
And he's
cute. He just wants to be on the video. So this was the first mug that I got given as a gift. I had a pen friend from the Netherlands and she came over to Manchester for work. So we met up. She knew that I collected all the mugs. So she got me the Netherlands mug.
Yeah,
and it's got
you?
Tulips on the back. And a windmill on the front. And it's bright orange inside. It's the first bright orange mug that I got. A lovely thought. It was the only mug I'd ever got given that I hadn't been to the place. So that meant that I had to go to the place. So I ended up booking a trip to Amsterdam a few months after. And that'll be in the next video because it's in a different series.
Stuttgart, please. Ooh.
So Stuttgart is a gorgeous sunny yellow. This was our fourth January girls trip. So this is January 2017 now. It's a lovely bright yellow. On the it's got the symbol of the horse, which I think is the symbol for the cars that they make there. And we went to the Jaguar Museum or the Ferrari Museum? The Ferrari Museum, I think. A horse is like the symbol of Stuttgart. And on the back is the big TV and radio tower.
Be on TV, don't you?
Yellow in the middle. Okay, next one. I love this colour. Dark green. I booked a surprise anniversary trip for me and my husband in June 2017 to Nuremberg in Germany. And we didn't know at the time, but when we got there, there was like a beer festival on our weekend at the big castle. The castle is actually on the back of the mug. It was a really lovely weekend. And they don't spell Nuremberg the same as us. They spell it Nürnberg. So this is the
it
first
mug.
It
looks like a smiley face.
It does. It's called an umlaut, I think. So this is the first mug that I'd got where it's not actually called what we call it. Dark green. Just try and get him to sit still, okay?
Okay.
Just for the video. Okay, do you want to pass me Cyprus? This is the one that Caitlin really wants to talk about, so I'm going to let Caitlin talk about Cyprus with you. You can hold it.
Okay, so this is Cyprus.
You might have to put it close to the camera.
So, it's like a dark brown. The reason that I don't like this mug as much, it does not have happy memories.
It does.
We went to Cyprus, and it was awesome. It was nice and hot. And one day we decided that we wanted to go to the capital and get the mug.
It wasn't the capital. It went to Larnaca.
Alright. It took us 3 hours to get to this place.
No, it took us an hour and a half to get there and an hour and a half to get back.
The only good thing about it was I got a free drink.
She got a free frappuccino.
And I spent 3 hours of my time in the hot sun.
It was really uncomfortable. We were on a scorching 2 buses there, 2 buses back. All for the mug. So we got back to the hotel and just pretty much jumped in the pool. Okay, next one. Can you pass me Morocco, please?
Oh, we liked Morocco.
We had a family holiday to Morocco in 2013. So this was another one where I'd already been to the place, but before collecting the mugs. So I actually bought this one on eBay. I saw it for a really good price and won the bid. I love the Morocco one. I think the Morocco mug is the prettiest Starbucks mug that I've got. It's so intricate. On the back are all the mountains, palm trees, and on the front are fountains and lots of tiled buildings. And it's a gorgeous light bluey purpley colour on the inside. I love the Morocco one.
Next
it's so
one.
Pretty. Prague.
Oh, the red one.
The red one. This was another eBay find. My husband actually bought me this as a present. He knew that I'd been to Prague years and years and years ago, but I hadn't got the mug.
And you're going there in January.
I am. It's our next girls trip in January. So I think I'm going to get the Czech Republic mug when I go there next. So on the back, it's got the St. Charles Bridge. I don't remember that much about Prague because it was years and years ago since I went. I think I was in college. It's red on the inside. And it was just a lovely thought. He got it off eBay because he knew I didn't have it in the collection. Okay, Portugal.
Portugal.
So our girls trip in January of 2018 was to Lisbon. So I decided to get the Portugal mug, which is a dark green. And Lisbon is, it's got a huge, huge harbour, it's on the coast, and boats just seem to be, the symbol of boats just seem to be everywhere in Lisbon. On all the lampposts, there was like a metal boat at the top to decorate them, so I wasn't surprised that this was on the mug.
That was like in Cyprus, do we always have like windmills?
Yeah, I know what you mean, there's windmills everywhere in Cyprus. Last one before we go downstairs and bring up some more.
No, there's two more.
Oh, is there two? Oh, can't see. Right, go on, Dublin.
Oh, I love Dublin.
Dublin was a girls' trip for me and Caitlin. We went in February 2018. We had a couple of nights there. I'd never been to Dublin before, neither had Caitlin. It was so expensive when we got there. But we did everything, didn't we? We did the Guinness Factory. We did a whiskey tour. We went to go and see the college and the library there. And we got this from the Starbucks that was just down the road from our hotel. We stayed in a Holiday Inn.
But like we also heard that when we went to the library, I think that's where they filmed a bit of Harry Potter.
I think they did, yeah. And it's got the bridge and the Liffey, which is the river on there. And we loved there's a bridge that goes over the river that's full of locks. It's absolutely
the
gorgeous.
Love heart.
Yeah, the Love Heart one. Okay. I know he's being good though, so he's fine. This is Playa del Carmen. Playa del Carmen is in Mexico. This was an eBay buy because I went to Mexico to Playa del Carmen in 2006. It was mine and John's honeymoon, and I really wanted the mug to represent the memory of our honeymoon. What you can see on the front is the main street in Playa del Carmen that we did visit, and on the back is the coast and all the palm trees, and it's a gorgeous turquoisey blue colour on the inside that just takes me back to the colour of the sea. We're actually going back to Mexico next year in 2020, but we're going to the other side of Mexico. We've not been back to Mexico since our honeymoon, so we're really, really excited about that. I think that's the last one that we've got up here at the moment, so we're going to put you on pause for a minute. We're going to take all these down and bring up the final batch. See you in a minute.
You just stay there. So this is the last batch.
We're back. I'm out of breath going up and down the stairs now. Right, could you pass me Florida, please?
Which colour is that?
Green.
Oh, found it.
So this is an eBay buy. I'd been to Florida in 2001 with all of my family, way before you were born. 2003, and when I was pregnant with Caitlin in 2008. So this was an eBay find because I wanted to commemorate all of those memories.
And then
we went to Florida last year, didn't we? We did go back to Florida in 2019. And in another video that I'll be filming in the future, you'll see all the Disney mugs, the Disney Starbucks mugs that we got. Okay, nice one.
We've just been watching Gavin and Stacey as well.
Wales with the dragon. I've been to Wales many, many, many times. I decided to get the mug on the last trip to Wales that we had, which was in 2019. Do you remember going to all the branches of Starbucks and not being able to get the mug? So we went to loads of branches of Starbucks, couldn't get the mug anywhere because they'd sold out, so we ended up having to order it off eBay when we got home. Okay, the next one is Egypt. Do you want to tell this story?
Oh.
This is another eBay Starbucks mug because we couldn't get it in Egypt.
Mum was injured for like the entire holiday after this.
We were in the middle of nowhere in Egypt and there was no Starbucks mugs for miles and miles and hours around. I asked repeatedly at the hotel and this is the answer I got. Do you want to hear the answer?
Yes, we have lots of mugs. You will find them that you will like. We have ones with King Tut and the pyramids and people on them.
Yeah, they didn't understand that I wanted a Starbucks mug and they were just trying to sell me any Egyptian mug. So it was an eBay one. It's brown on the inside and it has the pyramids on the back and
the lotus flower on the front.
I know. South Africa. So I went to South Africa in 2008 with work. Again, it was before I started collecting all Starbucks mugs. Yeah, it was cool. And it's lime green in the middle. This was a present off my husband. He very, very kindly bought it for me off eBay because he knew that I didn't have the mug from my trip. It's got animals on the front and a tree on the back. Let him go. Okay. Right, last one. Oh, it's the last one.
Reminds me of Lion King.
So the last one was bought in September 2019 of this year. We went to Mallorca. We unfortunately were a long, long way from Palma, which was the only Starbucks that's on the island, apart from the airport. But when we were at the airport, it was the middle of the night and the Starbucks was closed. So I had to get the Spain mug when I'd got home from Mallorca. We're actually going back to Mallorca next year. And
the same place.
To the same hotel. And we're hoping to get the Balearics mug. I will definitely be making the trip into Palma to get that one.
We loved it.
So this is Spain. And on the back, it's got the lovely Spanish sun and birds, which is quite fitting from your memories of Mallorca because you were naming all the pigeons, Bob.
Yeah, me and my friend were naming like pigeons and carols.
Thank you so much for watching our video. In the future, we'll be doing a You Are Here series for all my You Are Here Starbucks mugs and a Been There series for all of my Been There mugs. We might also do a Disney mugs collection, what do you reckon? Yeah, and you've seen Deacon as well now, so he's part of our channel.
Also, once we film the other videos in the next few weeks, we'll also put the links in the description below, so you can click on them once we film.
Thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye!
Bye.